Hello, my friends, and welcome back once again to Life's Biggest Questions, the channel that looks to answer any and all questions you may have, regardless of how wild or out of this world they may be. Today's question, though, isn't as far-fetched as one may think. Make sure, of course, that you are subscribed and hit that bell notification so you could always be the first to have all the answers. I'll be responding to some comments from a previous video toward the end of this one, and I encourage you guys to drop us some comments or questions you'd like answered. If you're lucky, we might even choose one of your suggestions. Now let's get into it. All right. Although the idea of great white sharks going extinct might bring joy to those afraid of attacks, such as surfers and divers, it may not be such a good thing for the ocean. And as of now, it seems they aren't going to go extinct anytime soon, but it's surely a possibility that could have some serious consequences. Join me today as we explore what if great white sharks went extinct. Great white sharks are considered one of the kings of the water. When they're younger, they mostly go after smaller prey like fish or rays. But when they grow as big as they do, and we're talking up to 20 feet and around 5,000 pounds, they tend to hunt anything and everything, from sea lions to whales, with bigger sharks and orcas being their only real threat. But if these guys went completely extinct, well, it would have a massive chain reaction across the board. A good example would be the following. If great white sharks are no longer hunting seals, the seals will then overpopulate because they won't be fed on by the sharks. The overpopulation of the seals could lead to the extinction of other small fish, especially considering how seals are known to overeat. Eventually, this would lead to there being little to no fish in the area where the seals are, which would lead to either the seals relocating, the seals overpopulating and starving to death, or both. The extinction of one animal can clearly affect many others down the line. But let's explore this idea more. It seems the chain effect would continue, with species slowly going extinct because they're either starving to death from overpopulation, or they're going extinct because those above them on the food chain aren't being controlled in regards to population. This, of course, would have very serious effects on the ocean as a whole, as it would lead to an unbalanced ecosystem. It could also lead to us having a tougher time enjoying fish as a delicacy, and it may even see the price of certain fish go up, especially if they too are on the brink of extinction. But with that in mind, keeping certain fish from going extinct would be another issue we would have to deal with altogether, which in turn could mean less of an abundance of resources that come from the water for us to use. Things like medicines, and obviously fish that we eat, may become more of a treat than a regular occurrence. For all we know, governments may even set new laws to protect certain areas and waters from being harmed, out of fear it could drive other fish and water animals to extinction. This could then lead to us having less opportunity to enjoy the water recreationally. From cruises to fishing in general, certain areas may be restricted. It could also lead to fishermen, and those who rely on the water in general to possibly find new jobs, if their area of work is now considered protected. And if we were to explore the idea even more, countries might have to completely change their shipping routes as well. But of course, this is just a hypothetical theory of what could potentially happen if great white sharks do in fact go completely extinct. And even so, the ripple effects wouldn't happen for many, many years afterward. But still, something to think about. So how likely is it that great whites actually do go extinct? Well, it's most likely not going to happen in the next 5 years or so, but some statistics aren't too promising either. As of now, they're considered vulnerable on the World Wildlife Foundation's website, meaning they aren't going to go extinct immediately, but if we continue to overhunt them and use them for personal gain, it's not looking so good. Now, what do I mean by use them for personal gain? Well, it's a known fact that many people sell great white sharks' teeth, jaws, and fins for considerable amounts of money. Many believe their fins have natural remedies and healing powers, which make them a hot commodity, especially in Asia, where shark fin soup is popular. As of now, there is a fear that if fishermen keep overhunting the ocean's top predators, they will be classified officially as endangered. There is a bit of concern off the coast of South Africa, which is known for having a ton of great white sharks, but have seen a decline in population as of late. And although they've technically been classified as a protected species in 1991, people still go after them. The good news, though, is that great whites are still doing quite well off the coast of Australia, Canada, and the US. So as of now, we don't need to fear our entire ocean's ecosystem collapsing. But if we continue taking advantage of species the way we do, well, then everything may change. As always, please do let me know your thoughts on this video in the comment section down below. Do you want to see a world without great whites? Why or why not? You guys gotta let me know. And make sure to subscribe so you guys never miss a video, and hit that thumbs up button if you enjoyed. For now, I'll be responding to some comments from the video, "What would happen if the moon disappeared?" Mr. Brian the Hedgehog said, "What if doom was real? I will never ever give up." I will say I've seen that comment a lot on a lot of our videos, and just keep going with it. The more you guys comment things, you know, the more likely we are to notice it. I've definitely noticed your comment. Obviously, we all have to agree on a topic. It's not kind of just like one person says, you know, we're doing this and that's it. But with that being said, if we get enough people kind of asking the same question, well, eventually we might actually do it because we want to give the people what they want, right? So you guys got to keep letting us know in the comments down below what you guys want to see, and hopefully we'll choose your question. The leopard said, I get freaky on a full moon. Well, I guess that means that you just turned from a leopard into a werewolf. That's what you meant, right? Athron Cohen said, if the moon disappeared, then at nighttime, people will collide with each other. It will be a massacre. I love how extreme that just got. It goes from the moon disappearing to people bumping into each other to a massacre. Are you saying people, it would be a massacre because people would just walk into each other and the collision of them walking into each other would cause injury, or people would take advantage of the night? I don't really understand how it would be a massacre, but I did find it funny, so I did include it. Anyways, guys, that does it for this video. I've been your host, Jared Bronstein. Like I said, be sure to give this video a thumbs up if you enjoyed it, subscribe, and of course, drop us a comment down below with your thoughts or a question you'd like answered, and we'll see you in the next one.